I don't know if there's a simple answer to this, but it just, you know, something about your touchdown to interception ratio, which is remarkable. It's all-time great stuff. But how do you avoid interceptions?
Well, I mean, I think the easy answer is probably some sort of accuracy. You know, we're just limiting the number. You know, there's always going to be those borderline plays, you know. But I think if you're putting the ball in pretty good spots, you're going to eliminate a lot of the opportunities. Now, there's some that you can't do anything about, you know, tip balls or guys falling down or slips. But the ones that you can, you know, placement of footballs and seeing the field and making the proper reads, you know, I think I've, you know, been pretty good over the years of just not throwing too many of those bad ones. You know, like I said earlier, where you kind of just don't see a guy. Just haven't been too many of those over the years. And, you know, I've had some guys who can make contested catches too over the years. You know, I think James Jones and Doherty and Devontae is really good at it. And, you know, that helps obviously avoid interceptions and just trying to always be smart with the ball and learn, you know, when it's the right time to take chances and when it's time to check it down and move on down the road.
You got 4 interceptions over the last 2 seasons. That's 847 attempts. Sam Darnold, 4 interceptions last night in 32 attempts. I mean, it's remarkable stuff with what you're doing. So maybe the exact science is throw it exactly where you want to throw it and make sure you have receivers that are able to contest, you know, each ball that you throw.
It's percentages. You know, you're just playing the percentages, the highest percentage pass on each play and you know, and usually that goes along with the lowest interception percentage per throw. And, you know, I've been pretty good at that over the years, taking care of the ball. You know, that was kind of how I grew up in the game, was knowing if I didn't take care of the ball, I was going to get benched, you know, in high school, in junior college, at Cal. You know, and you just kind of knew that was the way you needed to play, you know, and didn't want to play timid or scared. So I had to learn to really time up my feet with the routes and throw the ball accurately and throw the ball on time and, you know, try and eliminate those, you know, those really bad decisions that lead to bad picks.
For more Dan Patrick Show, tune into Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV, stream for free on BR Live, or download the Dan Patrick Show app.